Okay, so this is a talk about RepRap philosophy. You probably know RepRaps, the 3D printers. So these are two people that I like to thank. That one is Richard Stallman, the creator of the free software. The other is Adrian Boyer, the guy that started the RepRap project. This is an example of evolution of RepRap. This is the first RepRap done, Darwin, where this is the Mendel. Mendel was the second one. After that, we had the Mendel Prusa. So our replicating machine, the end of shopping waste and industry, this is what we hope for. So there are two key of biological phenomena of the self-replication, like the kittens that are born from the mother, and self-assembling. So like the self-simple replicator get complicated replicator to the assembly, like rhinovirus does using us, Homo sapiens, to replicate. This is an example of a machine, like the, done from John von Neumann. Symbiosis. Symbiosis is very important for RepRap project. Like with flower, the bees are attracted by flower from the nectar. So thanks to the nectars, actually the bees help the flower replicating. And like chickens and humans, we actually raise chicken for the eggs, for the meat. So that's another example of symbiosis. This is our greatest powerful technology, which is genetic engineering. So these are two examples of genetic engineering equipment that we use, some of us, every day. So now we have a machine that is self-replicating in almost all parts. Pretty much 50% of the RepRap should be replicable, printable. Exists symbiotically with people because it gives us good, like a glass or a comb, and evolved by breeding because since it's free hardware, we can actually modify the hardware and make something new. So the RepRap philosophy, if you actually read the page, is an example of Marxism. So what would Marx, the first things he got it right, the second two no, because actually we don't actually need another war, you know? New project can help us. So this the RepRap project is a self-replication machine that makes other useful stuff as well, as the wheat and the cow does. The cow does the milk for us. So this is an example of industrialization. A RepRap can basically replicate itself in 24 hours, and in that 24 hours can also give us a comb. So if we exponentially, in like 3 months, we can have a RepRap for every person on Earth. So also diminishing the needs of transportation and waste. So the RepRap wealth is wealth without money, because you don't actually make money, real money, with RepRap, because of the replication things, you actually save money because you start to print things that you need every day, like a comb, like was the example. The widespread adoption of RepRap would also reduce transportation, and this is an example of universal construction. So after what Adrian Boyer said in the paper about philosophy page was open pharma, because with the technology of RepRap, we could actually build a machine that could actually synthesize or combine the drugs in order to actually make the chemicals that they were used to buy. And this would disruptively liberalize the chemical treatment of disease, of course. Being the nature of a man, we were going to be like some people, we were going to be tempted to create new drugs, but if you follow free scientists, you should be safe. So these are some facts about RepRap machines. The RepRap can copy about half of its own part. The other half hardware you can buy in shops online. A RepRap should cost around 300 euro. A normal volume is 20 × 20 × 20 centimeter cubic. And they got a new general public license, and a print rate is about 30 millimeter per hour. So pretty much one day to replicate it with 50% of the parts. So this is an example of breeding. Here on the left side, we have Adrian Boyer. The other guy, I forgot his name, he's from New Zealand, and that is the child of a Darwin. So we have the first and the second Darwin that was back in 2008. So it's like MP3 for music sharing, but for real solid stuff, ultimately any stuff. That link is for an open source car. So it pretty much is the frame, but we can print all the rest. Maybe. Who knows? I'm done.